So from time to time I get people asking me about sharing a numbers spreadsheet with somebody that's, say, on Windows and using Excel. And people automatically think, well, I can go to export to Excel, send them an Excel document, and then they work on it and they send it back to me and I have to import that into numbers and you go back and forth and it seems rather clunky, and it is. Especially since Excel really doesn't work with multiple tables per sheet in the way that numbers does and all of that. So a much better way to share your spreadsheet with somebody that either is on Windows and uses Excel, or maybe for some other reasons doesn't have numbers, or just about any platform that they're on, is to share it using the Collaborate feature. So here I've got a sample numbers spreadsheet. I'm going to go and save it. And I'm going to save it to my iCloud numbers folder, although you don't necessarily have to. And once I save it, I'm now going to go and turn on collaboration. And this will allow other people to see and edit the document. So I'm going to hit collaborate. And I get to turn on share options here. So I'm not going to worry about adding people right now. I'm just going to turn on share options. And for this example, I'm going to say anyone with a link can actually view and edit this. But I'm also going to add a password. So I'm going to go in here and add a password. And I'm going to set it. So now this is a password protected sheet. So sending this to somebody, it's not as insecure as you might think, because they need the password to get in. But by not using the people I invite means they don't have to have an iCloud account. So anyone with the link, and I can set it to view only or make changes. So choose which one you want. I'm going to say they can make changes. And I'm going to hit copy link as the way to share with them. Now I could do mail and just automatically send an email message. But I'm just going to hit share. And now it's going to copy the link to this in my clipboard. And I could paste it into an email. I can paste it into messages, whatever I want. So now this is shared. And you can see Collaborate's turned on. It's green and all of that. So now I'm going to show you what it looks like if somebody else gets a hold of this link. You send it to them. So let me go and create a new private window in Safari. So this is a private window. The reason I made it private is it means I'm not logged into anything. That's what, you know, the privacy does. I'm not logged in. There's no cookies. None of that. So it's kind of simulating if somebody on another Mac got this link. I'm going to paste the link in. You can see here it's iCloud.com/numbers and a long thing. So this could be somebody on Windows and, you know, on Edge browser. It could be somebody using Chrome on any machine. They go to this link and this is what's going to happen. It's going to load up the spreadsheet and it's going to ask them for a password. It's that password that you created, and I'll hit OK. And now they have access to that spreadsheet. It gives them a little welcome message there. And it asks them for a name because it doesn't know who they are. You haven't used an iCloud account. So this person is just an anonymous person at this point. So we'll just do test guy and hit join. Great. And it tells you here under shared that there's test guy and the original owner. Great. And there's colors. A little pinkish color there, yellowish color there. Now I can view the spreadsheet pretty much with the same functionality you have in Mac Numbers, just that it's in a web browser. And I can make changes. So I can change this 106 to 107. Now look what happens when I go back to Numbers here. You can see that 107 was updated. The updates happen in real time. So I can actually move these windows around so you can see the private browser here. So this is the other person. And then this is me in Numbers here. And you can see wherever I click, they see in yellow, and wherever they click, I see in red. And numbers can be made in real time and reflected in both. Now it's very instant here, but you know, somebody halfway across the world with a slow internet connection, it may take a second or two to update. But and you know, you don't have to be on. You cannot be using this spreadsheet at all. This could be closed. They could access it at a completely different time, view things, make changes, and then you go back to the spreadsheet, open it up again, and then you'll see those changes reflected there. So it's a great way to share spreadsheets with somebody. They don't need to have numbers. They don't need to have Excel. They just basically need a modern web browser on a device, and they'll be able to go and view and edit the information and you don't have to mess with exporting to Excel and re-importing back in. We'll be right back.